Hello, it's Sara, and I took a little U-turn. Well, not a U-turn, but I'm doing stained glass. I had a piece in mind that I want to do for Fran, and it is houses, and I created this pattern, and it's super simple, like super basic, because there's no curves. It's all straight lines. I wanted to just start out with the most basic shapes, and so I went and got this graph paper, and it's the big kind. It's 17 by 11. Anywho, that's what I came up with, and I just colored it in so that I could get an idea of what it looked like, what the shapes look like. I've changed the window in the middle. I made it smaller. And then none of the other houses have windows, but I made a cross mark like that instead. And it'll show up as a solder line. And then I may use the metal wire to make like designs and stuff. So after you create your pattern, then you have to make a couple copies. So I should actually make a whole one big copy of this. But your printer doesn't do that. I'll do it because I think I'm going to ruin this. Because once I get everything done, it gets messed up. So anyway, so I made copies of sections of it. And so that I could cut this apart, because you're going to want to make patterns. So I have all the houses then in paper that I can cut apart. So I've already, yesterday I did some, and I made it too monochromatic. I used too few colors. So I've just gone down and I've gotten a few other colors, because Fran kind of wanted it. It's for her bathroom window. And she kind of wanted it in, I think she said, lavenders and teals. And I'm not sure, I don't remember if it's a teal, like a green teal or a blue teal. I think it's a blue. Anyway, I just pulled colors that I had, and I'm hoping for the best. So I decided on black roofs. So I've already cut the glass for the roofs. And I'm just going to place them on top of the pattern. And I'm going to show you the steps that I take to get us to this place, because by the time we're done, we want to fill in this whole entire puzzle with the pieces that you're going to use for your mosaic, for your stained glass piece. I have chimneys. This one's looking rough. I should straighten that. I think I will. And then I did one red door and a window. Now remember, I changed the pattern. I'm gonna do one window, but I have, so, and then I did this house in this color. Gotta figure out what color doors to make. And I'm going to do this purple house in a clear purple, because this one is in an opaque. It's not really opaque. There is some transparency to it, but the other one is definitely, and I really don't love the glass, the purple glass that I have. I think purple is a hard to get color, and so anywho, I'll show you. So that's basically it. That's all I have right now. But I have to cut apart all these other pieces. So I'm going to put this out of the way and show you the next part. So I have this house. This is the house that I want to do, and these are the doors. I'll just put them there. This is this house over here, and then this is the middle house. So I kind of want this house back there to be this color. And this is awful. This glass has this weird bumpiness and these weird bubbles in it. So it's hard to cut. But because I'm doing straight lines, I think I'll be okay. So I think that's going to be this one. And then for the middle house, I have this, which it's not even really purple. On one side, it's gray. And on this side, it's like a iridescent, but there's a little blue and purple and gray in it. So I figured I'd just use it for the middle house. And then this house I'm going to do in this blue, which is not even close to that blue, but I'm just going to do it and see what happens. So what I have to do to accomplish this, and then I have to figure out what color the doors are going to be for the two end houses. So let me do this one because I want to show you something. So on this pattern, or on this glass, I told you it has a bumpiness to it. So I'm just cutting apart these pieces. There's only three of them. This is the flatter side. This is the bumpy side. But I think that would be considered the front. So in order to get this pattern on the right way, I'm not going to glue everything. Let me think. I could glue this to the front, but I don't want to cut. That's what it is. When you cut, you want to use the flat side to cut with. So I'm going to glue them on the back. That's what I'm trying. That's what I'm getting at here. All right. So I'm going to use, I think I'm just going to use this edge and glue everything down to the edge. And then I can just cut. It's a good way to save your glass too. So I'm going to glue those down just using a glue stick. I'm just going to use my little Ranger one that I got from my class. And I'm going to put the glue all over it and then adhere that down to the glass up against the edge. So it just saves me one edge to cut. I'm going to grind it. I'm going to, I guess it's considered, well, it's called grinding. I'm going to use my grinder. And I'm going to try and bring the camera downstairs because I do all the glass stuff downstairs. I'll try and bring, I can't bring this tripod because it's already been finagled for me to shoot from above. But I'm going to bring my little tripod and see if I can show you a little bit of how I do this. I'll just do this house on camera, so I'll show you the process. And so that, I would do that with all the pieces. All the, I'm going to cut those all apart and glue them down to the color of glass that I want to use. And I'm using these Pen Touch pens to write on the glass with, because it'll stay on, because you'll see why. So this is number 8, 12, 11. Because I need to know where they go, which I kind of do. And when I put these in the grinder, I'm gonna get my other tripod and try to show you how I cut this. I'm gonna take this downstairs. Show you the cutting process and the grinding process. And so I'll be back in a minute to show you that. All right, we're in the basement. This is a, you know what, I have a chair here. Maybe I'll sit. Anyway, I don't remember what these are called. This says Morton Glass Works, but it's like a cutting board. So what happens is, it has a grid on here and all the little shards of glass fall down into it when you're cutting. So I have that. I also have these tools and I don't remember what they're called, but I could probably figure it out. And listen guys, Google is your friend. So anything you need to know, you can find on Google or go to a stained glass website. So this has like a lippy one there and a straight one here, and see, we put this little smiley face on top. That was when I took my class, because that's where you want it on top when you break the glass. So I have that, and this thing is what I usually use to cut with. It has like a little, I don't know, a line in it there, but this is what you use to break the glass with. Then you're going to need a glass cutter, and this is just, they sell these at Hobby Lobby. There's a little blade in here, and it doesn't cut you, but it cuts glass. And then I have this little, what is that? A sponge, glass cutter oil. So I have some of that on a sponge, and I just roll the blade on it. Then you bring your glass in here, and this was the one that I said would be tricky, possibly. So I've glued everything on the back, on the smoother side, and I'm going to attempt to do some cutting here. Hopefully you'll be able to see me. And I just hold my finger on the front. Yeah, you can see me. I'm going to come across. I start on the edge, and I'm going to try and make the line, oops, as close to my, oops, see, I fell in. I hate this glass. There are a little, this is going to be horrible. I don't think I'm going to be able to do it. I'm going to have to cut these again because the blade is falling in. Maybe it would have been better to cut it on this side. Let me just do the other one since I know I'll be successful. So I'm going to take it, and the idea is you want to get, save as much glass as you can. So I've gone all along the edges here, and then I'll have this whole big piece left over when I'm done. So you start on the edge, and you put pressure, and you go as close to your paper as you can. And this one I'm just going to go straight because there's going to be a spot. And I can sometimes just break it with my hand. So you break it like that. But see, I've gone pretty close to that edge. And let's just get this off here too. So I'm going to try and go as close and down here just to get this piece of glass off the main piece of glass. And you can hear it. See, I fell in a hole again. So it might break. The glass might not break correctly if you do that. Like if you have a little ding, and sometimes the glass is just cut like that. It's just so. And then for this piece, I'll stay on the edge of it, but I'll just go around like that. And this is a good example of what you use this tool for. Oops, upside down. Let's see, it cut it on an angle, so I can just put this away and trim this up. Now I'll show you. You really do want to try and stay as close to the paper as you can, because it just saves you having to grind all that. And this is how I get all cut up, because I am so reckless when it comes to this. But I'm going to try and get this off too, because you can use this little, I don't know what it's called, but you just kind of break it off. And I should be wearing protective lenses, but I can grind this, so I'm crunching it right now. But so basically I have a good shape, but I'm going to grind that. So I set it aside. So I'll do that all throughout. See, I fell in a hole again. This glass isn't being my friend today. I've had this glass cutter for a long time too, and I don't know how long they last, or when they get too dull. Ugh, I am falling in a hole. I think, I don't know if I'm going to be able to cut that. I might have already, where'd I put it? Oh, here. That worked just fine. So I'll grind that one. So I would go around all my pieces. Let me see if this blue is going to be, oh, this is nice and smooth. The back of this is nice and smooth. The other side is very bumpy. But I'm going to try, attempt to, just take your time. And I can break that off. try and stay as close to that paper line as possible. So this piece isn't that difficult because I really tried to keep it with the majority. Well, it is. This actually has no curves in it, this whole piece. So that was a little off. But I'm going to take, I'll take some of this over to the grinder to show you how I finish it up. But I'm going to have to bring the pattern down here to actually lay it on top of it to show. So see, I got that. This looks really close. This one I'm going to have to do some grinding. Let's see. So I guess you get it. You get the picture. This one is very disappointing because I really wanted to use this glass. Maybe I should try cutting it on this side. I really don't know what to do because I wanted to use this purple glass. But hey, maybe it's not meant to be. Which side I started on. Yeah, there's like little grooves and I can't, I keep falling into them. Well, that seemed to work. Let me just, see, I'm falling. Let's just see if I can get a decent break. I think I'm going to just, we'll see. It's no real big deal because I can just recut the pattern and put it on a different piece of glass, but I want to see. That wasn't so bad. Actually, this one looks really good. I think I can make do with that, but yeah, it's a pain in the butt. You really, for beginners, maybe just get the smooth glass when you first start, but I'm going to try and get this. I think this piece might come out okay, but if I can't get all of them, this is one house, so I have to be able to. That's decent. I'm gonna have to do some grinding. Like you can see that little edge, everything has to come right up to the paper so that it fits in the puzzle. You know, it's like a puzzle piece. It has to fit together. I mean, you have, it's not, I don't think this is as it's to me, it's more fixable than quilting. I can't fudge quilting as much. I can fudge solder though. I can fudge the soldering process a lot easier. So that's not bad. Alright, I think I'm doing it. I only needed three pieces for that little house in the back. Hey, I'm doing it. Okay. So I think I'm gonna, I have to go get the pattern and then I'll take it over to the grinder. Alright, and I'll be right back. Alright, so this is the grinder. It's an inland grinder. I'm going to turn it on. That's not too loud. There's a little sponge, which I could probably replace. Actually, I'm going to flip it. But this has to, it keep, oh, this is falling apart. It keeps the glass wet as I grind. Sorry, I could have done that off camera. And there's water in the bottom of this. There we go. Just drying my hand a little bit. And then these are the pushers that I actually am really loving because, and they're a mess because I'm so rough. But when I hold the glass with my hands, I really mess up my hands. I have protective glasses on. And basically you just take the piece of glass, which I'm gonna use something that I think was a pretty good cut. Where is that piece? This one. This one was a pretty good cut, right? And you wanna, this accomplishes a couple things. It actually makes the glass less sharp, so it dulls the glass down, but it also, I can make it the size I want. So let's just go ahead. So I have really taken that edge now right up to the paper. So that edge is really right up to the paper too. This one's a little bit further away. See me grinding the paper there. So I have a feeling this one's pretty good to go. So I'm gonna take this now and drop it into this. I have a little bin over here. This is my little, I drop it into this. Well, I can't really see what I'm shooting. There we go. This is just a little tub of water, and that will take the paper off the glass. And then I put it on the drying towel. And then I'm going to fit it into the puzzle over here. I'm going to fit it in. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'll grind another one. See if I can grind something. This one looks really close too. So basically, if you cut your glass as close as you can to the pattern, that'll save you a ton of work. So that's what I try to do. I'm not the best at it. But you can really see. You can get that right up to the paper. Good. I'm going to drop it in the water. So this is basically it. I have to go through all these pieces and grind them, and then we'll fit them into the puzzle. So I'll be right back. Okay, I want to do that purple house. So it's 8, 11, and 12 or something like that. So I'm just going to push the paper off. It's a little sticky. So we'll just get that off there. But I wrote the numbers on with that marker upstairs. And drop it on the towel. I'm going to dry my hands. I have another old nasty towel over here. I'm going to just try and turn this so that you guys can see. Well, this is my basement. Let's see. There we go. I'm just drying these off. And this is gonna go here, so I can move up the camera a little bit. And I gotta figure out what color I wanna make these doors. But this is number 8, and we'll hope for the best. Looks a little big. Let's see. Yeah, I gotta grind a little bit off there. For whatever reason, I don't know why, because I thought I really hit the edge of the paper really well on these. It isn't always a snug fit. Like, yeah, this looks super huge. They look big. So I don't know what's going on. If when I printed it, let me see if this looks. No, it looks the exact size. So then what I do is I'll take a Sharpie, which I have a Sharpie down here, luckily. So yeah, I definitely have some trimming to do. I'm going to try and get this in the shot. I'm going to flip this so I can see. So if you look, like this one's a great example. Here's the top of the line, but you can absolutely see there's a smidge of glass there before it'll fit. So I have to go around each and every one pretty much and take off a smidge. I don't know why, but this one's actually not bad. I think that one will be okay as long as this fits. So really I have to wait till the end to really make sure. But I'm going to take a smidge off of this one and this one to get those to fit. I had to do this yesterday. I have no idea why the paper isn't sufficient to get it to fit the way it's supposed to fit, but I definitely have some smidgen to do. But I like that color. That's going to be good. I'm glad I switched it. And then this is the light blue, and this, so I'll actually, I'm going to go ahead and finish grinding and get it all ready, and then I'll bring it upstairs and you can see it when it's all assembled. And then the next step is to add the copper tape. So I'll be back.